Hello students, as you know that we are revising the chapters that are going to come in your exam. So we have revised chapter number 1, 2 and 4. So in today's session we will combine all the three chapters together and revise them in short. So let's begin with the chapter 1, food. Where does it comes from? So what are the different topics that we have studied? First we have studied about definition of food. What is food? Food provides us with the energy. It helps in our growth and development, and it prevents us from various diseases. Then we have studied about sources of food. What are the two different sources of food that we have studied? The two different sources of food are plants and animals. Then we have studied the different parts of plant used as the food. So what are the different parts of the plant that we consume as a food? We have studied that plant is a versatile source. So the different parts of the plants like roots, stem, leaves, fruits, flowers, etc. are consumed by us as a food. We have also studied the different examples. I hope you have gone through that examples. Then we have studied about milk products. From where do we get the milk? We get the milk from the milk animals that are like cow, goats, camel, yak, etc. So what are the different products that can be made from the milk? Butter, ghee, cheese, curd, ice cream, etc. Then we have studied the different eating habits of animals. What are the different eating habits? According to the eating habits of the animals are classified into three categories. What are that? Herbivorous. What are herbivorous animals? The animals that consume only plants are known as herbivorous animals. Then we have studied carnivores. What are carnivores? The animals that completely depend on the other animals for their food are carnivores. And then we have studied about omnivores. What are omnivorous animal? The animal which depend both on plants as well as animals are known as omnivorous animals. Then we have studied about scavengers. Scavengers are the animals that depends on the dead plants and animals. We have also studied the different examples of the same. So, I hope the chapter number 1 is clear to you. Then, we have studied chapter number 2, that is components of food. In our first chapter, we have seen that we consume the variety of food. So, our food consist of the different components. So what are the different components that are present in our food? The different components present in our food are carbohydrates, proteins, fats, vitamins and minerals along with roughage and water. And these components of food are known as nutrients. Then we have studied the detection test for carbohydrates, proteins and fats. We have also seen the different chemicals used to carry out these tests. Like for carbohydrates, we use iodine solution. For proteins, what different chemicals did we use? We used copper sulfate and caustic soda solution. So how we can confirm the test for carbohydrates and proteins? If we observe the change in color. In carbohydrates, we will observe the blue-black color, and in proteins, we observe the violet color. And for the fats, if we see the translucent patch on the piece of the paper, that confirms that the fats is present in that given food item. We have also studied the different food items that contains carbohydrates, proteins, fats, vitamins, minerals, roughage, etc. And we have also studied the different role of these nutrients in our body. Like carbohydrates and fats are known as energy giving food. Proteins are known as bodybuilding food. Vitamins and minerals protects us from various diseases. Roughage helps in the digestion of food. And also we have studied the uses of water. Water helps to absorb the various nutrients, it helps to keep our body hydrated, etc. Then we have studied about balanced diet. What do you mean by balanced diet? The diet which contains the nutrients that are required for our body in a definite proportion is known as a balanced diet. That is, not too much or not too little of any nutrient should be present. Our body should be supplied with all the essential nutrients that are required by our body. Then we have studied about deficiency diseases. What do you mean by deficiency diseases? The disease that is caused due to the deficiency of some of the nutrients in our body. So what different deficiency diseases we have studied? First, we have studied if there will be a deficiency of protein, what we will observe that our growth will stop. Proper growth will not take place. The discoloration of hairs, swollen face, etc. If both carbohydrates and proteins are absent in our diet for a long time, what will happen? The growth will be completely stopped. The person will appear lean and thin due to deficiency of both carbohydrates and proteins. Then, deficiency of vitamin A will lead to night blindness. Deficiency of vitamin B1 causes beriberi. Deficiency of vitamin C causes scurvy. Deficiency of vitamin D causes rickets. Deficiency of some of the minerals like iodine will lead to goiter. Deficiency of iron will lead to anemia. And deficiency of calcium will lead to weak bones and tooth decay. So, due to the deficiency of some nutrients, we can observe the different diseases. So, how these diseases can be cured? If the proper amount of nutrients are supplied to our body, we can cure these diseases. So, I hope you have the topics in the chapter number 2 are understood to you, and you have revised all the topics that we have studied in our previous sessions. Now, let's see chapter number 4, that is sorting materials into groups. Why do we group the materials? We group the materials based on our convenience. So, it will be convenient for us if we group the materials, as it will be easier for us to locate and count on them. We have also studied that the different materials are required to make the different objects. And one object can also be made using the different kind of materials, isn't it? We have also studied the various examples for the same. To make an object, we choose the material based on its property and for what purpose the object is to be used. So, to study the property of the materials is also very important. So, what are the different properties of the materials that we have studied? First, we have studied its appearance. Based on the appearance, we have classified the objects into two types, lustrous and non-lustrous. What do you mean by lustrous? The objects which have shine, or the materials that possess shine, are known as lustrous, and which do not appear shiny or have the dull appearance are known as non-lustrous. Then, second property was its hardness. If we try to compress the material by our hand, if the material compresses, then it is known as a soft material. If we cannot compress the materials from our hand, then it is the hard material. We have studied the different examples also. Then we have studied the solubility. What do you mean by solubility? If the substance, if we add a solid in a liquid and that solid disappears or get dissolved in that liquid, then we say it as a soluble substance. For example, salt and water. If we add salt in water, the salt completely disappears in water. It is said to be soluble in water. And insoluble, if we add sand in water, do you find that the sand disappears in the water? No, it will not disappear in the water. It will not get dissolved. Why? As it is insoluble in water. When salt is mixed with the water, it forms a solution. Where salt is a solute and water is a solvent. If we add a large amount of a solute in a solvent, the solution will become more saturated. So, and water is also known as a universal solvent. Why water is known as a universal solvent? As it dissolves large amount of substances in it. Then we have studied miscible and immiscible liquids. When two liquids are mixed together and they form a one phase, no two distinct layers are seen, such liquids are known as miscible liquids. What are the different examples? We have studied the example of vinegar when mixed with water. Vinegar get completely mixes with water. No two phases are seen. So, it is known as a miscible liquid. And another is immiscible liquid. What do you mean by immiscible liquid? If two liquids are mixed together, we find two distinct layers of both the liquids. Such liquids are known as immiscible liquids, like oil and water. If we add oil in water, what happens? Does it mixes together? No. Two distinct layers are seen. Such liquids are known as immiscible liquids. We have also studied some of the objects float on the water while some sink. Why this happens? Because some of the objects which are less dense, which have a lesser density than the water, floats on the water. We have seen the example of dry leaf, wood, block of wood, etc. Even ice floats on water because it is less denser than the water. While the objects that have high density or are more denser than the water sinks in the water, like metal key, coin, etc. They are denser than the water. Then we have studied about transparency. Based on transparency, the objects are classified into three: opaque, transparent, and translucent. What do you mean by opaque? The materials through which we cannot see on the another side are known as opaque. Example, we have studied of cardboard. And many different examples you can write for the opaque substances. The substances through which we cannot see. Then transparent. The substances which allow to see on the other side are known as transparent substances. Like glass, some of the plastic, water, etc. Then translucent. The materials that does not allow, that allows us to see on the other side but not clearly. We cannot able to see clearly on the other side. Such materials are known as translucent materials. What were the examples? Butter paper, etc. So the different topics we have revised from the chapter number 4. And we have revised all the three chapters in short. I hope you have understood all the three chapters. Now let us solve some of the questions based on all these three chapters. As we are discussing the questions, I will ask you to write the correct answer in your notebook and check afterwards whether you have written the correct answer or not. This can help you to test yourself. Okay, so shall we start with the question number 1? We group the materials for our convenience and also for some other reasons. Materials are grouped together. So, we group the materials for our convenience and some other reasons. So materials are grouped together as similarities in their properties, differences in their properties, or both on differences on similarities and differences in their properties, or none of the above is correct. So materials are grouped according to, what will be the correct answer? Option number C. Both on similarities and differences in their properties, we group the materials. Isn't it? Next, the property of a substance that decides whether it will float or sink in water. So, which property of the material of the substance will decide will it float or sink in water? Its volume or density? Its density. We have studied that the substances that are less denser, which have the less density, floats on water, while the substances that have high density sink in water. So correct option is B. Third, the following are the milk products. So which of the following options are the milk products? First option is butter, ghee. Next is sugar and salt. C is butter and flour. And fourth is ghee and sugar. So which one is the correct option? Option A, that is butter and ghee, both are milk products. Fourth, the root part of the following plant is eaten by us. So which of the root plant part of the plant is eaten by us? First is radish, carrot. Option B is potato, ginger. Third is tomato and brinjal. And fourth is mint and spinach. So which of the option is correct? Which of the options are the roots of the plant that we eat? Option A, radish and carrot. Fifth, the substance is starch that gives blue-black color with iodine when tested. So, when we do the test for the iodine, we get blue-black color, which indicates what is present in it. Starch, is it true? Yes. It detects the starch in the foodstuff if we get the blue-black color. So, this statement is true. Sixth. Spongy and the bleeding gums are the symptoms of. Bleeding gums and the spongy gums are the symptoms of which diseases? Scurvy, rickets, night blindness, or beriberi. These are the symptoms of scurvy, which is caused due to deficiency of which vitamin? Vitamin C. So the correct option is A, scurvy. Seventh, which nutrients can be identified by using copper sulfate and caustic soda? So which nutrients can be identified? Carbohydrates, proteins, fats, or vitamins? So correct option is option B, that is proteins. Copper sulfate and caustic soda are used in the detection for proteins. Now, the column A and column 1 and column 2 are given. You have to choose the correct options and see which of the following, which of the options matches with your answer. First is A, coconut oil. So what do you think, coconut oil? It is immiscible in water. So A pairs with S. Next is vinegar. Vinegar is miscible in water. So A, B pairs with R. C is dry leaf. Dry leaves float on the surface of water. C pairs with P. And glass marbles, which are sink in water. So D pairs with Q. So A with S, B with R, C with P, and D with Q. So you have to choose the correct option. So which one is the correct? Option A. 9. Dash helps in protecting our body against diseases. So which of the nutrients helps to protect our body against diseases? Is it vitamin or protein? Vitamins helps in protecting our body against diseases. So option A is correct. Dash is a universal solvent. Oil or water? Water is a universal solvent. So correct option is option B. Sugar is obtained from where do we get the sugar? Sugarcane, beetroot, both A and B, or none? We get sugar from both sugarcane and beetroot. Which of the following does not have luster? So which of the following do not have luster? Options are iron, wood, gold, and silver. So what do you think is the correct answer? Wood, option B, as iron, gold, and silver are metals. They appear shiny, while wood appears dull. It does not have luster. Last is, select the object from the following options which have shine. So plastic toy, steel spoon, wooden spoon, both B and C. So which of them have shine? Answer will be only B. Steel spoon only shine, while plastic toy, wooden spoon do not shine. So I hope you have got all the answer correct. So we will end our session here.